بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And very good day. So we continue for our subject biomedical engineering and application. So now the topic is on biotechnology, right? We'll cover few important points in this topic, which is quite interesting. It's to do with cell culture and also flow cytometry. But this part will be covering up to cell culture, so flow cytometry will be in the next lecture. Okay, what is biotechnology? General description is to use living things to create products or to do tasks for human beings. I mean, we use biotechnology as the practice of using plants, animals, microorganisms such as bacteria as well as biological process. For example, it is used in industry, medicine, agriculture, to produce foods, medicine, test for diseases and remove waste. It can also be used to solve problems and conduct research. So through research, there are so many products is available nowadays in the line of biotechnology. Over time, biotechnology has performed the basis of learning about people and disease. Biotechnology has also underpinned the development of treatments. So this is quite an advancement in this field. Technology based on biology, biotechnology means technology based on biology. Biotechnology harnesses cellular and biomolecular process. That means it's to do with the biomolecular process and also cellular to develop technologies, products that can help human lives and the health of our planet. Okay, that's a simple introduction. Recent advances in biotechnology helping us prepare for and meet society's most pressing challenges. Here's how one of the points that we want to focus is how to heal the world. So biotech is helping to heal the world by harnessing nature's own toolbox and using our own genetic makeup to heal and guide lines of research. By one is to reduce rates of infectious diseases. So if you see there is an infectious diseases, for example, previously is influenza, so nowadays, for example, we have COVID. So people are working on this field in the biotech to identify how to reduce the infectious diseases. So they are trying to come up with the vaccines as well, and they have said that the vaccine is available in some part of the world. We are not sure. So this is the contribution of healing the world, saving millions of children's lives, for example, in a particular disease which is correlated with the children's, changing the odd of serious life-threatening condition affecting millions around the world, which is happening now. For example, the COVID-19 is one of the example. Tailoring, adapting treatments to individual to minimize health risks and side effects, that's one example. Creating more precise tools for disease detection. So nowadays, if we have a particular disease which is threatening our society, so we want to have a quick results. So for example, for COVID nowadays, it takes up to 2 to 3 days. So it will be better if we can get an immediate response. For example, in hours. So if we can reduce from day to hours, hours to minutes. That is something to do with the biotechnology contribution, the field of biotechnology. So we have to find out the tools, create a precise tools for disease detection and also combating serious illness, everyday threats confronting the developing world. So this is happening nowadays. So we need to be what we call proactive and move in this direction so that we can identify the possibilities of these diseases and also the tools that can be used to help the mankind. Next, we move on to the from the heal the world to fuel the world. So, biotech uses biological processes such as fermentation, harnesses biocatalysts such as enzyme, yeast, and other microbes to become microscopic manufacturing plants. So biotech is helping to fuel the world by the steps in chemical manufacturing processes by 80% or more, and lowering the temperature for cleaning cloth, potentially saving 4.1 billion annually, improving manufacturing process efficiency to save 50% or more on operating costs, reducing use of and reliance on petrochemicals, using biofuels to cut greenhouse gas emission, decreasing water usage and waste generation. So nowadays people are focusing on waste generation, how to reuse the waste and also produce some green products, tapping into full potential of traditional biomass waste product, something to do with the number 7. So trying to find a new potential. Then feed the world. This one is what we call another important point, that biotech improves crop insect resistance, enhances crop herbicide tolerance, facilitate the use of more environmentally sustainable farming practices. So they're helping to feed the world, generating higher crop yields with fewer inputs. So kalau tengok Malaysia sekarang ni, kita ada padi, boleh menuai padi berapa kali dah? Bukan sekali dah. Sekarang ni dah mungkin 2 kali, 3 kali setahun. 2 kali tu for sure. Some is going to, you know, to increase the times taken. So itu pun melalui biotechnology, lowering volumes of agriculture chemicals required by crops, run off this product into the environment. So nowadays people are going for organic products, crops which is non-pesticide, using biotech crops that need fewer application of pesticide, allow farmers to reduce tilling farmland. Developing crops with enhanced nutrition profiles, solve vitamin and nutrition deficiencies. So ada produk-produk tanaman yang dia kata apa, ada tambahan vitamin. For example, yang mengandungi vitamin tambahan. So this is all advancement in biotech. So producing food free of allergens, toxins such as myosotoxin, improving food and crop oil content to help improve cardiovascular health. So dalam banyak-banyak ni, satu contoh yang kita boleh tengok adalah sekarang ni kalau kita beli sayur-sayuran, so ada bahagian yang diasingkan, satu organic, satu lagi non-organic. Non-organic maksudnya apa? Dia menggunakan benda yang bukan organic, maknanya ada possibility yang dia menggunakan bahan kimia seperti racun dan sebagainya. Jadi kalau kita beli pun boleh guna, tapi perlu cara yang betul untuk dibersihkan. So biotech dia ada dua peranan, maknanya dalam mengawal keselamatan produk makanan yang dikeluarkan, dan pada masa yang sama juga menggunakan chemical base juga untuk amplify production, maknanya lagi banyak pengeluaran, contoh dari segi sayur-sayuran dan sebagainya. So kalau kita tengok Malaysia ada dah dia punya role market, contoh di Cameron, sayur-sayur dijual di seluruh Malaysia, ataupun kita import lagi daripada Australia, daripada mana lagi, negara Eropah, tapi ada juga sekarang ni daripada negara China yang masuk. Jadi ada banyak pilihan, tapi semuanya ada dia punya advantage and disadvantages. But these are the what we call challenges in the biotechnology field. Okay, this is example for feed the world. So kita boleh kategorikan kepada 4 bahagian: pharmaceutical, biologics, and diagnostic, and also agriculture. So I mean, in pharmaceutical, they create synthetic drugs, new vaccine, gene replacement therapies, So drugs ni ada yang non-synthetic. So sekarang ni dia produce a synthetic drug as well. Biologic discovery and isolation of natural compounds such as hormone, antibodies, proteins, yang ni di bawah biologic. Diagnostic, home and clinical detection kit for pregnancy, ulcer, cancer, strep throat, bacterial throat infection and allergens. So benda-benda ni adalah di bawah kategori diagnostic. Agriculture, stay fresh tomato, frost and disease resistant crop, biopesticide. So the these are the four groups that can be focused on the biotechnology product. Tapi kalau dari segi industry, so you can see there's so many. So from biotech in the middle, so you have pharmaceutical, agriculture, chemical, nanotech, information technology, medical device and equipment. Daripada IT, so there's so more breakdown. So digital healthcare, telemedicine, quantum computing, biological computing, optics. From chemical, you have industrial, biotech, molecular, electronics, and also protein peptide. So these are the very vast biotechnology industry, but you can still break down to smaller compound. But this one is sufficient to highlight the, how is the network is growing. Right. This one is, for example, what they do in the cell culture, and monoclonal antibodies, molecular biology. So it is vice versa, the flow cytometry and also vaccine production. So this is just a basic diagram to show the process involved for these three focusing part in the biotechnology. Now, let's move to cell culture. Okay, from biotechnology we go into cell culture. So what is cell culture? So cell culture ni maksudnya kita culture cell tu lah kan, maknanya daripada tubuh badan kita keluarkan dia dan culture dia di luar tubuh badan, maknanya di environment yang terbuka, yang mana environment yang sesuai untuk sel tu di apa dibiarkan. So refers to the removal of cells from animal or plant and the subsequent growth in favorable artificial environment. So kita boleh remove cell from the tissue directly and disaggregate by enzymatic or mechanical means before cultivation, or they may be derived from the cell line or cell strain that has already been established. Okay. Primary culture refers to stage of the culture after the cells are isolated from the tissue and proliferated under the appropriate condition until they occupy all the available substrate, i.e. reach confluence. Maknanya, mula-mula sekali apabila kita keluarkan sel daripada tubuh badan ataupun daripada plant ataupun animal, yang first first round yang kita culturekan dia, bila dia sel ni dah diletakkan di atas permukaan dan dia memenuhi seluruh kawasan orang kata apa dish tadi yang kita gunakan, satu bekas yang kita gunakan untuk sel. At this stage the cells have to be subcultured passage by transferring them to a new vessel, fresh growth medium. Growth medium ni adalah dia punya makanan sel yang kita feedkan dalam bentuk liquid to provide more room for continued growth. Cell line. After the first subculture, the primary culture becomes known as cell line or subclone. Maknanya daripada yang mula-mula tadi bila sel tu dah penuh di permukaan, kita subculture dia lagi, i.e. passage them. Maknanya kita culture dia semula, kita ambil daripada permukaan tadi dan kita masukkan balik dalam bekas-bekas yang baru dengan growth medium yang baru. So kita boleh nampak dia punya growth yang seterusnya. Yang ini disebut sebagai cell line. Derived from primary cultures have limited lifespan and as they are passage cells with the highest growth capacity predominant, resulting in degree of genotypic and phenotypic uniformity in the population. Next is cell strain. If a subpopulation of a cell line is positively selected from the culture by cloning or some other method, this cell line becomes a cell strain, maknanya involved with the cloning process. Cell strain often acquires additional genetic changes subsequent to the initiation of parent line. Okay. Saya akan tunjuk sedikit figures ataupun proses yang melibatkan cell culture. Okay. Right, ini contoh maknanya subjek lah, sama ada human, tikus ataupun ayam ataupun daripada ikan, apa-apa binatang. So kita isolate organ dia. Tu kita pilih contoh apa, kidney. Kalau kidney, daripada kidney tu kita ambil dia punya culture dia, tisu dia. Kita potong keluarkan, retain some tissue architecture. Okay. Dan kita pun suspend dia dalam media. Okay, and then kita let them grow dalam flask tadi, gunakan cell line. Ni dipanggil cell line yang ada dalam flask. So kalau gambar ini tengok, dia akan ada sel di banyak di permukaan tu. Okay. So in this part, actually we want to also know something about what is known as a genotype and also phenotype. Okay, yang paling mudah ialah gene. Cuba kamu ingat gene. Gene ni maksudnya apa? Yang benda yang dalaman. Phenotype maknanya di luaran. Okay, genotype, this is the internally coded inheritable information. Maknanya melalui genotype ni kita boleh dapat bacaan genetik, dia punya blueprint, dia punya internal part, dia punya DNA process ataupun dia punya keturunan, history, keluarga dan lain-lain. So ini adalah lebih kepada perkara yang diwarisi daripada keturunan keluarga. Okay, intimately involved with all aspect of life of a cell or organism. They control everything from the formation of protein, macromolecules to the regulation of metabolism and synthesis. So ini adalah benda dalaman. This is what we call genotype. Phenotype, it is called outward physical manifestation. So phenotype is the outward physical manifestation of the organism. The sum of atom, molecules, micromolecules, cell structures, metabolism, tissue, reflexes and behaviors. Anything that is part of observable structure. Maknanya daripada luar, kita boleh nampak dia punya function, behavior, maknanya dia punya physical dia. So itu dinamakan phenotype. So for example, dalam soalan kalau saya tanya, bandingkan genotype dengan phenotype. So you should be able to show the difference. Okay. So ditulis sini, the relationship between the genotype and phenotype is simple one. The genotype codes for the phenotype, dia kata. So macam ni adalah dia punya phenotype, dia punya gambar bunga dia. So ini adalah dia punya DNA strand, yang benda dalaman dia. So itu adalah genotype. Okay, upwards. So ni sama, explanation lebih kurang sama aja. So let's move on. Culture condition. Right, so dalam when we do cell culture, so you need to make sure that when you bring out the cells or the tissues from the any of the subject, so that you should maintain the same environment as inside the body, so outside the body. So basically you need to have the essential nutrients, growth factors, hormones, gases, oxygen, CO2, regulates the physiochemical environment, pH, osmotic pressure and temperature. So maknanya kita kena pay attention for all this. Barulah sel tadi kita boleh, orang kata apa, kita boleh culture dengan keadaan selamat. Kalau tak, sel ni akan mati apabila environment tak sesuai. Contoh, pH rendah ataupun pH terlebih, ataupun tak cukup CO2, ataupun kekurangan growth factor, hormones, ataupun dia punya nutrients, dia punya makanan dia, dia punya growth medium dia yang tadi saya sebutkan. So, ada je perubahan pada perkara-perkara ni, maka dia akan menyebabkan sel tu tak boleh hidup dalam environment yang kita culture tadi. Most cells are encouraged dependent, the need of normal cells for an appropriate surface to be attached or them to grow in cell culture. Maknanya, sel ni dia bukannya bila kita masukkan dia dalam flask, dia akan timbul dalam media ataupun growth media tu. Sebenarnya sel ni dia akan mula-mula dia akan terapung, tapi lama-kelamaan dia akan attach, dia akan mula melekat pada permukaan flask tadi. Dan bila dia dah mula melekat, dia akan spread, dia akan melekat dan dia akan mula menjadi apa, lebih orang kata apa, terlekat pada permukaan. Dan bila dia dah terlekat completely, barulah dia akan mulakan pergerakan dia. Dia akan bergerak, dia akan split, maknanya dia akan membahagi, dia akan menjadi daripada satu sel jadi dua sel, dua sel jadi tiga sel. So, sehinggalah semua permukaan tadi penuh. Bila permukaan semua dah penuh, maka barulah kita kena pindahkan dia. Ini contoh dia. Macam ni ada sel yang memanjang gitu. Ni sel yang besar. Ataupun orang kata lebih pada macam square. Ini bulat-bulat ni kan. Yang bulat ni maksud dia, apabila contoh kat sini dia ada kawasan-kawasan yang tak ada sel ni, semua kawasan ni dia akan penuh dengan sel. Macam dalam gambar ni. So it will become confluent. Dia panggil confluent maksud dia penuh macam ni. Kalau macam ni, ni belum confluent lagi. Kalau macam ni dengan macam ni, gambar dua gambar ni, dia adalah confluent. So let's look at morphology of cell in culture. Cells in culture can be divided into three basic categories. So based on their shape and appearance, i.e. morphology. So there is fibroblastic, epithelial like cells, and also lymphoblast. So fibroblast cells are bipolar, multipolar, have elongated shape, grow attached to substrate. Sama, cells are epithelial, polygonal in shape with more regular dimensions. Lymphoblast cells are spherical in shape and usually grow in suspension without attaching to a surface. So these are the three types, shape and appearance. Okay. This is again showing the process, how to process the cell culture. First, you harvest the cell, isolate the cells, apply the isolated cells to an appropriate growth media. Ini yang media yang saya sebut tadi. So you put the cells and the media cell culture by placing the culture dish in the cell incubator. Then verify the cultured cells are of the cell type of interest, and then you can perform the subculture to obtain pure culture or to bypass some problems such as senescence, biological aging. Cells are ready to be manipulated or modified for experimental procedures. So this is another complete flow of cell culture. Okay, then little bit on the cell culture of equipment. The requirements for any cell culture lab depend the type of work conducted. I mean, our cell culture laboratories have the common requirements, being free from pathogenic microorganisms, share some of the same basic equipment that is essential for cell culturing. So dalam cell culture, kejayaan cell culture ni, kita kena jaga daripada sekiranya ada infection, cross-infection, pathogenic, microorganism. Maknanya berkongsi alat-alat cell culture ni tak digalakkan. Maknanya device yang besar setiap kali orang lain guna, selepas guna dia mesti bersihkan. Dan orang lain pula guna pada waktu yang berbeza, bukan waktu yang sama. Supaya kita tak confuse dengan sel yang kita guna, tiba-tiba boleh tertukar. Bila tertukar sel, sekiranya tercampur, maka kita kena ambil balik semula sampel sel dan kena culture balik. So these are the basic equipments that been used. So this is just a list of what's the equipments required, and then expanded equipment, additional supplies. These are all the apa ni, bahan-bahan yang boleh diguna dan kemudian dia akan dibuang, tak digunakan semula. So a culture hood provide an aesthetic work area free of pathogenic. So let's look at how flow cell culture hood. So ini adalah cell culture hood. So dalam ni lah kita buat kerja. So maknanya dia ada separuh cermin macam ni. Atas ni cermin, bawah ni dia terbuka. So kita boleh letakkan alat peralatan di sini dan kita buat kita punya kerja cell culture ni dalam ni. Dan setiap kali tangan kita keluar daripada flow hood ni, culture hood ni, kita kena spray dengan 70% ethanol spray supaya kita matikan apa-apa kuman bakteria. Dan bila masukkan balik, so, bila keluar, kita nak masukkan balik, mesti kena spray. These are the basic layout. Okay, later you can look at some of the example to see how they do this cell culture process. There are so many videos online. So if you see, you will be able to what we call capture some of the important points, how they perform the cell culture. So cell culture is one of the major tools used in cellular and molecular biology, providing excellent model system for studying the normal physiology and biochemistry of cell. For example, metabolic studies, aging, effects of drugs and toxic compound on cell, mutagenesis, carcinogenesis. Carcinogenesis ni study regarding cancer cell. It's also used in drug screening, development, large scale manufacturing, biological compound, vaccine, therapeutic protein. So kalau orang nak develop vaccine, so bila vaccine tu dah siap ataupun dalam proses untuk kita identify which vaccine is suitable for which disease, vaksin tak boleh directly dicuba pada binatang ataupun pada manusia. Jadi apa yang paling mudah untuk kita gunakan adalah sel. So sel ni dalam bentuk cell line, cell strand yang macam tadi saya explain. So you culture the cell and then you test the vaccine or the drugs, the proteins ataupun new compounds on the cells. So dia adalah satu tools yang sebenarnya main peranan yang besar dalam biotechnology. The major advantage of using cell culture for any of these application is the consistency. The consistent cell ni sama je. And then reproducibility. So kita boleh ulang balik studies tu 4 kali, 5 kali, masih sama lagi sebab cell yang sama tu mana. Of result that can be obtained from using batch of clonal cells. Maknanya sekali kita culture, kita boleh perform the studies few times. Maknanya and then you do the same study on the same types of cells. So dia tak ada membahayakan macam kita test apa-apa drug ataupun synthetic drug ataupun vaccine ataupun compounds, biological compounds directly into human ataupun animal. So these are the important some of the important application of cell culture. So I think that's all for this session. Hopefully I would like the student to find out more example of cell culture application. I mean, why, where and how they use cell culture for which application in biotech or for example in biomedical. So go ahead and look for some example. Hopefully you will find some good example so that you can relate the concept of cell culture in the biomedical field or biotechnology. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.